Hi, in this video we'll be taking a look at the AQA June 2019 paper 2, okay, for the calculator paper, okay, and it's the June 2019 for the foundation tier. And in this video we're looking at the questions number 1 to 7. Okay, at any point guys, feel free to pause the video, have a go at the question and then press play, okay, for any question that you want to try or questions you want to try. This is question number 1. Circle the number that is 1 less than a cube number. So the cube numbers are 1, 8, 27, okay, 64, and 125. I'm not going to go any further because for the context of this question, we don't even need to go beyond 64 actually, but I thought I'd put the first 5 cube numbers. So if you look here, we've got number 27 because it's in its 20s. So which number is 1 less than 27? That's going to be that, because 26 is 1 less than 27, which is a cube number. Question number 2. Circle the fraction which is equal to 0.25. Now if you type in 0.25 on your calculator, it will come out as 1/4. Now we want to find a fraction that is equivalent, i.e. the same as 1/4. It can't be that, okay, because times in the bottom by 10 means that I times the numerator by 10, so it should be 10/40. Can't be that, because I times that by 25 and that by 25, so it should be 25 out of 100 and not 4 out of 100. Can't be that, because it has to be 2/8. So it leaves us with 3/12. 1/4, if I times 1 by 3, I get 3. 4 times 3 is 12. So that's equivalent, i.e. the same as 3/12. I've times 1 by 3 and 4 by 3. So it's what I call equivalent fractions, so same fractions. Question number 3. Here is a number line. 3 something something A something 4. We're going up in 0.2s. So 3.2, 3.4, 3.6, 3.8, and 4. Okay, so A is equal to 3.6. Now, if you're unsure of how I worked out this scale, what I did was I looked at the number of parts. So there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I did the number of, so like each part, 1 divided by 5 is equal to 0.2. So that means each bar goes up in 0.2s, if that makes sense. So the 5 comes from 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 parts. So there's 5 parts from 3 to 4. Okay, so I divided 1 part by 5, and that told me how much the jump is for 1 part. So it goes up in 0.2s every time. Question number 4. How many millimetres are equal to 3.27 metres? Well, let's convert it metres to centimetres and then centimetres to millimetres. So I've got to multiply this by 100 from centimetres, sorry, from metres to centimetres. So I can do this one of two ways. So times it by 100, I get 327. Centimeters, and then from centimeters to millimeters, I times it by 10. So I just add on an extra zero. Oops, that's come out a bit dodgy. Zero. So adding a zero, I get 3,270. Or alternatively, what you could have done is just do 3.27 times 1,000, and it will get you from meters to to millimeters. But I try and break it up, guys, to like make it a bit easier rather than do it as like one big sum. Question number 5. Which is longer, 3/4 of a day or 1,000 minutes? Well, 3/4 of a day, so a day is 24 hours, so 3/4 of 24, so 24 divided by 4 is 6, times it by 3 is 18. So 1 quarter of it, so it's 18 hours. If I do 18 hours, multiply that by 60, that will convert it from hours to minutes. So doing this on my calculator, 18 times 6 is 108, and then add the 0, so it's 1,080 minutes, and that's greater than 1,000 minutes. So that means which is longer? Well, 3/4 of a day is longer, because the answer for that is greater than 1,000 minutes. Okay? So that is the answer for question number 5, guys. This is question number 6, okay? 6 part A. Use a calculator to find out 9.75 cubed over 1.875. plus 6.4 squared. So let's just do this a bit at a time. So 9.75 cubed so I'm going to divide this number by 1.875. so let's just break it down. So when I worked out that, now on my calculator it's obviously truncated, so it's given me 926.85935 for 9.75 cubed. Okay, and then I'm going to add, okay, so 6.4 squared, so I get 40.96. so I've broke it up, guys, to make it a bit easier. So 6.4 squared is 40.96. 9.75 cubed gives me 926.859375. Okay, so if I divide that by 1.875 and then I press equals, well, that gives me 494.325, and then I'm going to add on 40.96. okay, so doing this on my calculator, and I get the answer here of 535.285. Now the question says write down the calculator's full display, so on my calculator it's come out as 535.285. okay, so that is my answer for part A. So what I did was broke it up, actually. So I worked out 9.75 cubed first, and I got the numerator. I then divided it by the denominator, which is 1.875. And then I added my answer to 6.4 squared, which is 40.96. Okay. So that is my answer for that, guys. For part B, is your answer to part A sensible? Check by rounding each of the numbers 9.75, 1.875 and 6.4 to the nearest whole number, and you must show your workings. So rounding that, yeah, is going to be 10 cubed divided by rounding 1.875 to the nearest whole number is going to be 2, and then rounding 6.4 is going to be 6 squared. Now 10 cubed, guys, hopefully you're happy with that. That's 1,000. So I've got 1,000 divided by 2 plus 36. Now half of 1,000 is 500. 500 plus 36 is 536, guys. Okay, which is approximately near our answer. So it's approximately near 5.35, actually 535.285. So it's slightly bigger than that, because we have rounded all of our answers upwards for this fraction. rounded this down. So overall, the answer's been rounded up more, but it's what I call a sensible answer because it's very close to 535.285, okay? So it has got a very small difference, okay? So I've got to add on, I think, 715. So if I add on 0.175 to my answer, okay? Oh, sorry, 0.715, not 175, ever, then it will get me from this decimal to 536. So that is a very small number, and that's how I know that my answer is sensible. Okay, so I hope you find it useful, guys. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Please like, comment, share, subscribe, and turn on post notification by clicking the bell icon so you don't miss out on further and regular uploads on my channel for Key Stage 1, Key Stage 2, Key Stage 3, GCSE and A Level Maths. Okay, thanks for watching, and there's going to be some more videos for the next series of questions for Paper 2. Thanks for watching, stay safe, stay healthy, and I'll catch you the next one. Bye for now.